What up, though? It's your boy Montez Allen, and welcome to episode number 9 of the Faith Based Merch Podcast. You can be listening to any podcast in the world, so I like to show an attitude of gratitude and really say I really appreciate you listening to mine, because it's quadruple, double billions of them in a world, and you're deciding to listen to mine no matter where you're listening to it at. So I just want to say thank you. And if you're new to my podcast is in a correlation with my brand, which is called Faith Based Merch, where I felt the need in the world right now that we're living in, a direction that we're going in. We need encouragement, we need love, we need faith, we need hope, we need iron sharpening iron. We need a collective group of people that will consistently do that for one another, because like I said, iron sharpens iron and one person sharpens another. And that's why I created my brand through dope faith-based merch and also through this podcast. So thank you for tuning in. And this week I got an excellent message for you. Excellent. And I think it could resonate with anybody on the planet. And that message is, don't lose your enthusiasm. Now, Winston Churchill, I know we've all heard that name. He was like a British statesman. I'm not a historical guy by any means. In history class back in the day, I passed, but I don't know how to this day. But he says success consists of going from failure to failure without losing enthusiasm. Or he said failure to failure without loss of enthusiasm. Now, that really hit home with me, because when you fail, most people give up after one failure. Most people give up after one failure. They fail one time and they don't want to do it anymore, right? Those are the people that didn't want it. I'm learning. I'm failing so much in my business that I'm learning ways that I'm learning that you fail your way to success. You're going to fail your way to success. And if you lose enthusiasm, that means you didn't want it in the first place, because you're going to fail over and over and over and over and over and over again. But you cannot lose your enthusiasm, because if you lose your enthusiasm, you didn't want it in the first place. If you lose your enthusiasm, that means your why isn't strong enough, right? If you lose your enthusiasm, you're giving up on your future. You're giving up on your kids. You're giving up on the people that are believing in you. You're giving up on God. You're choosing to settle. You cannot lose your enthusiasm when you're failing. And I understand how hard it is, because it's been plenty of times, especially me, I'm a first time business owner, right? And it's up and down, and thoughts come to you. What are you doing this for? You're not going to make it. Look at you struggling now, whatever it might be. But you got to know deep down inside and have this superior belief in yourself that it's going to work, that it either has to work or it has to work. But no matter how many times you fail, you have to keep your enthusiasm up, because if you don't keep that up, you fall into doubt. After you fall into doubt, what do you fall into? Depression. After you fall into depression, then you start letting things go. Like, I'm not going to make it. It's not going to work. Or whatever, you know, whatever your endeavor is, whatever your goal and dream is, you have to keep your enthusiasm when you're going after it, because you're going to fail a lot. The first time you're doing something, you're going to fail more than you succeed. Right? You're going to fail way more than you succeed. That's in life, period. Think about when you were a child and you were driving, when you were riding your bike for the first time. When you took the training wheels off and you were riding your bike. I kind of remember that moment. And I fell off my bike a lot. Right? I fell off my bike a lot. But no matter how many times I fell off that bike, I didn't lose my enthusiasm. I was excited every time. Now I know how to ride a bike without even touching the handlebars. I can ride a bike, turn the corners without touching the handlebars. But I would have never got to that point if I would have lost enthusiasm and gave up when trying to ride a bike after they took the training wheels off. Does that make sense? So don't lose your enthusiasm, man, because you're going to fail a lot and it's going to be very discouraging, right, on your journey. And again, I want a lot of you to get to know me more, you know. And I'm the guy that's running faith-based merch. I'm the guy that's on Instagram. I'm the guy that's on Facebook. I'm doing all of this on my own. And a real quick side note, I really appreciate everybody that has supported me, because it's been a lot of people. It's growing really fast. And I knew it was going to be like this because I'm like, the world needs this. So I'm just going to go ahead and give you a standing ovation. You deserve it. You the real MVP. Right? So I really appreciate people for rocking with me. But I it's tough doing a lot by yourself when you don't have the resources to hire an advertising agency and you're paying their advertising costs out of your pocket. And sometimes, you know, me, I've gotten some trouble with running ads because I didn't, when I first started, I failed a lot. I didn't know how to, sometimes I still struggle, but I didn't know how to really, I would be excited about getting sales from from running Facebook ads, but I didn't realize profit and loss, and the Facebook ad cost might outweigh how much my profit is. So I had to learn a lot when you're getting into something that you've never done before. You're going into deep territory. You're going into the deep waters. God is taking you to business, right? So you can't lose your enthusiasm when you fail hard. You're going to hit the school of hard knocks. I don't mean to sound cliche, but it's the truth. You're going to hit the school of hard knocks when you're attempting to achieve something that you've never achieved before, or maybe anybody in your bloodline has never achieved before, right? So you can't lose your enthusiasm when you're going after it, because common sense will tell you that you're going to fail, but you're going to fail your way to success. A lot of people are scared to start because they want to be perfect at it, but there's no such, you can't be perfect and get great until you start. And I say this all the time, you don't got to be great to start, but you got to start in order to be great. And a lot of people are scared of failure. Look, don't get me wrong, failure is annoying. Failure is really difficult to deal with, especially when you're doing it and you're trying your best over and over and over again, and it's still not doing. I'm talking about over and over and over again. That's tough. You start getting doubts. Am I good enough? Am I supposed to be doing this? But that's why Winston Churchill said, you cannot lose your enthusiasm, because you're going to fail a lot. You're going to fail more than you succeed. But the thing is, when you take those risks, the successes are so large that they outweigh the failures. I'm going to say that one more time. If you don't lose your enthusiasm, when you finally hit it out the park with your idea, with your product or service, or whatever you're doing, with that new course, with that new, you know, whatever you're doing, with that new part for a car, or, you know, whatever you're doing, I'm telling you right now, you're going to have to fail your way there. But when you hit it out the park, because it's going to happen, it's going to outweigh your failures. It's going to be so huge that it's going to outweigh your failures. And then the failures, you're going to be like, oh, that was necessary. And that's when looking back on it and saying, whoa, I needed to go through that. So y'all, don't lose your enthusiasm. Don't lose that childlike faith that we had when we were trying to ride a bike for the first time. Right? Y'all all remember that. Y'all, some of y'all still got scrapes on your knees, or that one scrape on your knee to this day from trying to ride a bike. Same thing goes when you were trying to walk for the first time. When you were trying to walk for the first time, you failed a lot. You kept falling down. But you didn't say, oh, I don't want to try to walk anymore. You didn't lose your enthusiasm. Every time you kept trying to do it with enthusiasm. Apply that to whatever you're doing today. Don't lose that. It seems like life beats you down sometimes so much that it can beat out that childlike faith, because the world is really hard, right? So don't lose it, y'all. Keep your enthusiasm. You have what it takes. Keep trying. Keep working. Keep pursuing. Don't give up. Never give up. Ever. Because if you give up, it's a 100% chance that it's never going to happen. Right? It's a 100% chance that it's never going to happen. But if you stick with it, there's a chance. All you need to do is be right one time. And it's a wrap. All right? So I hope you found some value into this message, And once again, if you've never been over to Faith-Based Merch, go over to faithbasedmerch.com. Help me build this community of faith-based, inspiring, iron-sharpening, iron-type people, type community that you don't got to be perfect to represent God. It's fresh like zest, and you can wear it in a lounge. You can wear it in church. You can wear it anywhere because it's dope faith-based merch. So make sure you click the link wherever you, what platform you're listening to this on. Click the link. Head over to Faith-Based Merch. Grab you some merch. I know you'll love it. Hope you have a blessed day. Peace.